Hi, well, thank you for inviting me to the Otley Music Festival, and thanks very much, Chris, for recording it. I'm playing it here because I've got my machine for the backing tracks with me, so you might hear that later on. This first one is a song by Jesse Fuller that Rambling Jack Elliott does, and it's his signature tune. I like it very much. It's San Francisco Bay Blues. I got the blues when my baby left me by the San Francisco Bay. Ocean mine, she goes so far away. Didn't mean to treat her so bad. Best girl ever did have. Said goodbye, made me cry. Wanna lay down and die. Well, I ain't got a nickel and I don't give a lie to die. Well, this song was written in 1939, about 5 years after the manufacture of the gramophone here, and it's quite a forward-looking song about Amelia Earhart and her second fated flight to America by Dave Red River McEnery. Flight was planned that day with her partner Captain Noonan on the 2nd of July. She fell into the ocean far away, and there's a beautiful, beautiful field in a land that is far away and fair. Happy landing to you, Amelia Earhart. Farewell, sweet lady of the air. Half an hour later, an SOS was heard. The signal weak, but still her voice was brave. In shark infested waters, her plane went down that night. In the blue Pacific, to a watery grave. And there's a beautiful, beautiful field in a land that is far away and fair. Happy landings to you, Amelia Earhart. Farewell, sweet lady of the air. Thank you. farewell, sweet lady of the air. Well, this is a song about the world's most evil man, Stackerly. Does. It's the Tennessee Stud.
Back around 1825, I left Tennessee very much alive. Couldn't have made it through the Arkansas mud if I hadn't been riding on the Tennessee Stud. Well, I had a little trouble with my girlfriend's car. One of her brothers was a bad outlaw. Left a message with my Uncle Judd, and I rode off on the Tennessee Stud. Well, the Tennessee Stud was lonely, the colour of the sun, and his eyes were green. came to big money and we forded a flood on the Tennessee Mare and the Tennessee Stud. Well, the Tennessee Stud was long and lean, the colour of the sun and his eyes were green. He had the nerve, he had the blood, and there never was a horse like the Tennessee Stud.
This is the last song of the first half. It's a traditional American song about an experienced sailor.
Down in the wild was singing along, finger on the trigger and the eye of the hog. Honey, let me be your salty dog. Salty dog, salty dog, I don't want to be a man at all. I just want to be your salty dog. I just wanna be your salty dog. Love that girl, sweeter than money. Lips around her mouth, are sweeter than honey. Honey, let me be your salty dog.
Second half. I've always been very keen on the American songs, but I also got extremely keen on the sort of things that that Bob Peck does. And this is an old one of that he wrote the tune for, and it's the words of Charles Corsley, The Ballad of the Five Continents. In blue Bristol City, at tall tide I wandered, down where the sea masts, their signals were shining. I heard a proud seaman on the poop deck reclining shout to the stars that about the ship blundered. On the high harbour lie six shifty daughters, their bodies are straight, their eyes are wide. Here is the key
of that very bed chamber. I haven't locked it, I replied, as I walked on Water Street beneath the blonde sun, the trees of cold Christmas screaming with starlings. Sweet screamed the birds as my delicate darlings scanned at my hand the black butted gun. Think of the collar, my bonny, my beauty. Think of the hangman with hands so red. Pray, pray that he does his duty. I am the hangman, I said, as I walked in Wine Street, the silk snow was falling. The night in her ancient hair hung her comb. Soft sang the yellow-faced seaman of home, the gong and the coconut fiddle recalling. In the vermilion forest, the dancer adorns with gold thorns his holy head. When God sees his hands, his fingers, I am the dance, I said. In Bread Street in summer, we saw the boys hauling the Yankee white wheat on the bowl of the bay. Between us the sword of the sun where we lay, bloody with poppies the warm sky are shawling. Sly sing the sirens on the coast of California, the oyster finger, the easy eye, twining their tune in the gin-wicked palaces. The song is mine, I said. Down by the dockside, the green ship's groaning, ten rows ride in the ragged sea. Blessed are they with a laurel tree. Now in the brow stands a saint for the stoning. Sound the salt bell on the mound. Prayer in the pool of the dead. When the storm strikes, speak the word on the waters. I am the word, I said. I am the prince, I am the lonely, I am the damned, I am.
Song by Sidney Carter, who wrote some questioning songs and also some hymns and some rather shady songs as well. So very mixed, very much a mixture. Never knew what you're going to get from Sidney Carter. It was on a Friday morning when they took me from the cell, and I saw they had a carpenter to crucify as well. You can blame it on the pilot, you can blame it on the Jews, you can blame it on the devil, but it's God I accuse.
You can blame it on to Adam. You can blame it on to Eve. You can blame it on the apple, but that I can't believe. It was God that made the devil and the woman. Barabbas was the killer, and they let Barabbas go. But you have been crucified for nothing here below. And God is up in heaven, and he doesn't do a thing. With a million angels watching, and they never move. Carpenter, I said, I wish that a carpenter had made the world instead. Goodbye and good luck to you, our ways will soon divide. Remember me in heaven, the man you hung beside. It's God who ought to crucify instead. I said to the carpenter, the hanging on the tree.
Well, this is a song by Bob Dylan, who's very important to me and very important to nearly everybody, I think. But this is not a very well-known song by Bob Dylan. It's one that he wrote when he split up from Sarah, so probably in his 30s, and I heard it from Wiz Joan and Ralph McTell when they came to Otley and did a beautiful version of it, so I try to emulate that. It, Abandoned Love.
I can see the turning of the key. I've been deceived by the clown inside of me. I thought that he was righteous, but he's vain. And there's something telling me I'll wear the ball and chain. My patron saint is fighting with a ghost. He's always somewhere else when I need him most. The Spanish rune is rising on the hill. I love you still. I come back to the town from the flaming moon. I see you in the street, I begin to swoon. I love to see you dressed before the mirror. Won't you let me in your room before I disappear? Everybody's wearing a disguise to hide what they've got left behind their eyes. Me, I cannot cover what I am. And wherever the children go, I will follow them. I march in the parade of liberty. I've given up the game, I have to leave. The pot of gold is only make believe. The treasure can't be found by men who search, whose gods are dead and whose queens are in the church. We sat in an empty theatre and we kissed. Off your list. My head tells me it's time to make a change, but my heart is telling me I love you, but you're strange. So one more time at midnight by the wall. Take off your heavy makeup and your shawl. Would you come down from the throne on which you sit? Won't you let me feel your love before I abandon it?
Right, well, that was nearly it. This is my last song, and I'd just like to say thank you very much for Chris Smith for recording this, and also to Paul for running the music festival in these strange times. And this one's the one that I know Paul likes, so I'll do it for him. So, Richard Curry, if you're watching, you can put your fingers in your ears again now, because this is Brian and Michael's Matchstick Men from Manchester. He painted Salford smoky tops on cardboard boxes from the shops, and part of ankles where I used to play. And I swear he once walked down our street, cause he painted the kids without on the feet, and the clothes he wore had all seen better days. And he painted matchstick men and matchstick cats and dogs. He painted kids on the corner of the street in the sparking clocks. Now he takes his paint and he waits outside the factory gates to paint his matchstick men and matchstick cats and dogs. They said his works of art were dull, no room around the walls at all, but Lowry didn't say much anyway. He, they said, he just paints cats and dogs and matchstick men in boots and clogs, but Lowry said that's just the way they'll stay. And he painted matchstick men and matchstick cats and dogs. He painted kids on the corner of the street in the sparking clock. Now he takes his paint and he waits outside the factory gates to paint his matchstick men and matchstick cats and dogs. Now canvas and brushes were wearing thin when London started calling him to come on down and wear that old flat cap. They said, tell us about your ways and all about those Salford days. Is it true you're just an ordinary chap? And he painted matchstick men and matchstick cats and dogs. He painted kids on the corner of the street in the sparking box. Now he takes his paint and he waits outside the factory gates to paint his matchstick men and matchstick cats and dogs. Now Lowry's hanged around the wall amongst the finest of. And even the Mona Lisa takes a bow. But
that tired old man with hair like snow told Norman folks it's time to go. The fever came and the good Lord mocked his brow, and he left his matchstick men and matchstick cats and dogs. He left his kids on the corner of the street in the sparking block. Now he takes his paint and he waits outside the pearly gates to paint his matchstick men and matchstick cats and dogs. Goodbye.